Hey, this is Victor Antonio, and welcome to my Tales from the Sales Side. Personal stories about my selling experience that shifted my way of thinking. Now, many years ago, I got an opportunity to become Vice President of Sales for Latin America. Now, large company, $3 billion company, says, Victor, we're going to nominate you to be Vice President of Sales. You have to move into the region. We wound up moving into Latin America, specifically in Buenos Aires, Argentina, right? And so, up to that point, the company had been in the market for more than 10 years. And in that 10 years, they've never surpassed $14.1 million. Now, my boss at the time, we'll just call him Lynn, was basically, Victor, I'm putting you in this position. I believe in you. Whatever you do, don't sell less than $14.1 million. You'll make me look bad. In so many words, that's what he was saying. So I remember we moved the family down to Argentina. I'm there 3 months. Now, the company's based in Minnesota. Yeah, for sure. You betcha, right? So 3 months into my stint, my boss calls me up, says, come back up here. I just want to talk to you, see how things are going. So I go up there, fly up to Minnesota, and I still remember walking into his office, right? You know, it's one of those intimidating offices with the beautiful bay windows, you know, mahogany desks, shelves, everything, expensive art on the wall. And I can see Lynn sitting behind a table. Secretary walks me in, and he's like, Victor, how you doing? I said, I'm doing good, Lynn, about yourself? We exchange some pleasantries. And then Lynn says to me, he asked me this key qualifying question, Victor, what can I do to support you to make sure you're successful? Ooh, what a great question, right? What can I do to support you to make sure you're successful? What a great leader question, right? And I remember I thought about it. I looked at him dead in the face. I said, Lynn, if I had better pricing, I know I can sell more in that region. Let me say that again. If I had better pricing, I know I can sell more than $14.1 million in that region. That's how I said it. And he just looked at me, didn't say a word, stared at me, didn't say a word. And after 5, 10, maybe 15, 20 seconds, but it seemed like a minute or two, he finally breaks the silence and he says something like this. I said, Victor, let me ask you a question. Now, stop right here. When your boss says, let me ask you a question, it's not going to go well. So he said, Victor, let me ask you a question. To which I said, yes. He goes, if the only way to be successful in that region is to discount our products, to lower our price, why don't I just fire you, close the offices down, get rid of all the salespeople, and just send them a brochure? He says, why do I need you if I can just send them a brochure and I'm not going to sell on value? And I remember I looked him dead in the face. I said, Lynn, I don't know who brought up the subject about pricing, but I suggest we move on. And that was it. That was the end of that pricing conversation. And what he told me directly or indirectly was, we don't sell on price, we sell on value. Figure out a way to sell on value. Now, some of our products were about 30, maybe even 50% higher than our competitors. So we really had to sell on value. And that's the message I took away from that meeting. Sell the value, not the price. And I remember months later, one of my regional managers comes up to me and says, Victor, I know I can grow this region within Latin America if I had better pricing. What do you think I said? And I mean, his name was Eduardo. I said, Eduardo, if I have to lower our price just to get more business, why don't I fire you, close the office, and just fire everybody there and just send everybody a brochure? What do you think of that? It's exactly what Lynn told me. And see, when I got everybody on the same page in terms of we don't sell on price, we sell on value, things began to shift. Now, it took a while to turn this mental ship, but we did. Within 2.5 years, we had gone from $14.1 million to $98 million in annual revenue. The biggest shift was that we learned to sell value, not price, which is why I always say, position your value, not your price. This is Victor Antonio, always reminding you that selling ain't hard when you position your value and you know how. Take care.